Astronomers are surprised. Again? Really? Surprised? In this recent Nature article, a very small star has been described that has a very large planet orbiting, and the two are so very close. According to the self-referential contemporary settled science, this is impossible because gravity can't cause this arrangement to come about. And so a popular press release said, astronomers just found a giant planet that shouldn't exist. Wall Thornhill used to call this science by press release. Why shouldn't exist? Well, because no theory of gravity can make such a small system come together in that way. So we're going to have to sit through all kinds of going back to the drawing board, so to speak, where all the gravity theories are twiddled and twiddled and tried to make this work. Now, it's very hard to draw these solar system scales of what this new system looks like. It's very small compared to our solar system. The tiny star has 1/5 the radius of our sun, and the planet going around it is so close that it would be only 1/10 the distance of the planet Mercury to our sun. And this tiny planet goes around the star once every 3 days. This hardly qualifies as what we think of as a solar system. And it reminds me of how in biology, most of the cells in your body are roughly the same size when you compare them to bacteria. Bacteria are very small, about 1/50th or 1/100th the size of your body cells. And if you saw a bunch of other cells that were 1/100th the size of your body cells, you might actually propose that they're different. They are something else. They're a different species, they have different functions, but they somehow live together and in harmony with what you call your cells. My point being that there is absolutely no need to force these tiny cosmic systems that we're discovering into the same category as what we're familiar with as a solar system. These tiny systems might be entirely different creatures with entirely different functions and life cycles. So if these small systems cannot form due to the action of gravity, how might they form? Hannes Alfvén, the Nobel Prize winner, father of plasma cosmology, said that gravitational systems are the ashes of prior electrical systems. In other words, electrical forces cause solar systems to form, and once they are formed, the system can hold together through gravity. If you have electric current flowing through a cosmic plasma, there are many structures that will naturally form. And one of them looks like this. These twisted current pairs collect matter and concentrate the matter, the dusty plasma of the interstellar medium, and they even bring the heavy elements, such as iron, into the very center of the rope, while the lighter elements collect at the outer edges, which is exactly what we see in stars and planets. Now, the electrical force is very well suited to forming such concentrations of matter. And if we go back to our favorite Alice and Bob, though I forget which one is the gravity cosmologist, let's say Alice is. If Alice has a gravity cosmology, she won't be able to understand or explain how this tiny system came about, and she'll have to go back to her drawing board and look at it all again. Whereas Bob, who has an electrical cosmology, he actually, long ago, predicted that we will find all kinds of pairs of stars, pairs of planets, stars and planets, all these, we might say, proto-star systems. So if we go with Bob's plasma cosmology, we are not surprised by these tiny systems, although I'm not saying we have all the details worked out. We just have to rethink the model of solar system formation. And yes, there's a lot of work to do here. For example, why would the star pinch off from the rope? Is the rope not a continuous line? And that gets into further instabilities in plasmas, the favorite being the sausage instability, where a flow of electric current through a plasma, it's called an instability, it naturally breaks up into smaller beads. Smaller beads naturally appear in a cosmic current flow. Now, these plasma structures are in complete agreement with Maxwell's equations. If you run this setup in a computer, you'll see these structures arise. But the computer gives a very low resolution, granular result. in these systems in nature, there's trillions and trillions of particles, whereas computers can really only handle still thousands. But see, this often happens in physics. There's an observed fact that's in agreement with your theory, but it's extremely difficult to start with the theory and then step by step derive the known result. This is the physics versions of Gödel's idea that every logical system will have true statements that cannot be derived from within the system. Once a generation of brilliant scientists will propose a new model or combine previously established models to create a new field of study for the rest of us. The aforementioned Hannes Alfvén did just that by combining Maxwell's equations with the equations for fluids, giving us magnetohydrodynamics. And that allowed previously intractable electromagnetic problems in space to be solved using known ways of handling fluids. And this opened up decades of further research. However, even the first generation after Alfvén had forgotten his own stern warning that he made, which is that he had done some extreme simplifying assumptions. And no scientist should ever confuse his simplified model with what nature was actually doing. For example, in his simplified model, he had to remove the possibility of stationary electric fields in plasma structures, the most famous being the electrical double layer. And so vehement was the ignorance and the hubris of generations subsequent to Alfvén that if you proposed that we might find electrical double layers around, say, the Earth, you were called stupid and unfit for your post. Even after the satellites went around the Earth and returned the data of the electrical double layers surrounding the Earth, there were still the occasional statements opening up in papers of, since we know there can be no electric fields in space, ... Of course, now geophysicists acknowledge these structures are everywhere, but there is zero apology for squashing the careers and the reputations of all the scientists who first proposed the ideas. Well, all ranting aside, I'm only trying to point out that an electrical cosmology predicts that we will see all kinds of pairs of objects which are formed through the action of electrical currents in space and are now held together as gravitational systems.